Germany, like most places in Europe, is full of historic buildings and steeped in history. There have been wars and tragedies that have left spirits lost and doomed to wander the land for the rest of time. Lucky for you, we have got a list of places you should never visit, unless you're looking to be cursed or at the very least terrified. So let's jump into the top 5 haunted places in Germany you should never visit. In at number 5 we have Berlin Citadel. The citadel was built in 1559 and is known as one of the best preserved military structures in Europe. It was originally built to protect Spandau from attack. Built specifically to have no blind spots, giving an advantage on all sides in the event of an attack. The citadel has seen a lot of destruction and war since it was built, but the most famous ghost to live there is the spirit of Anna Siddo. Anna was married but had a love affair with Joachim II, the local ruler at the time. As the ruler was dying, he asked his son to take care of Anna. The affair had been frowned upon, but as both of their parents had passed, they had grown closer before he got sick. When he passed, his son didn't keep his promise. He immediately imprisoned her in the citadel. No one ever saw Anna again after that. There was no explanation as to where she had gone or if she had been punished for her love affair with the ruler. There had been reports from visitors of the White Lady, a ghost seen walking around the citadel late at night. Some felt a sudden cold breeze and feeling of dread while walking around the grounds, but still there was no explanation. Years later, the citadel was a big tourist attraction and renovations took place. While they began to renovate, they found the remains of Anna. She had been walled into a cell and left there. This seemed to confirm the rumors that she was the White Lady for all these years. Some people have seen her late at night, but others have felt her presence. Even after she was found, her spirit had remained. If you visited today, you might catch a glimpse of her if you were to be there after nightfall. Coming in at number 4 we have Swiftkopf Castle. The origin of Swiftkopf goes back to the prehistoric times. A fort was built there in the 1st century AD. It sits on the edge of a lake covered in all sides by water, making it the perfect place if you're worried about intruders. The castle was built in the early 13th century by King Ottokar. It is not known when it was built, but the first written mention of the castle was in 1234, when it was owned by the King of Bohemia. It had many owners throughout the years, being seized in wars and passed to new rulers. It is now owned by the National Heritage Institute and is open to guests. It is regarded by locals as the creepiest place in Germany. Many refuse to visit or leave before it gets dark, as not to disturb the spirits they believe to live there. They believe that the castle is home to a dark supernatural entity. They believe it had been since prehistoric times and has never left the land. There are often voices heard from around the castle. Technical faults happen, often with no explanation. It's also been said many animals refuse to go into the building and act strange on the land outside the castle. There have been many times where the staff had lit candles to light up the halls when night falls. There have been times when every candle had been blown out at once, sending chills down the spines of anyone in the area. The most haunted part of the castle is the main tower. There are reports that if you sleep in the tower, you will pass away within the year. There are at least 2 confirmed cases of this happening throughout the castle's history. Coming in at number 3, Osnabrück. Osnabrück was once the site in a major pagan temple and burial area. The pagans decided that they would attempt to convert the German people to the Christian faith. This led to a massacre taking place at the temple. The local forces took the lives of those there, including the priests. They then desecrated the graves and broke their altar stones. The pagans built their temples and buried the dead on sacred land. It is believed that this act disturbed the deep magic infused in the land. Now, every year during the winter solstice and summer equinox, something strange happens on the land. Strange orbs of light have been seen moving around the area. Screams are heard from miles away. Stains appear on the stones that still lay there today. Although the town have now been built away from the graveyard, you can still visit today. Many locals avoid the land as the spirits there seem angry about what happened to their descendants. It is thought these spirits wield great power and could have revenge when and if they choose to. If you do choose to visit, you need to be warned to be respectful. Do your research before and careful when you arrive. Many have reported seeing terrifying things or feelings like being watched while there. No one visits during the solstice and equinox, as this is when the spirits are the most active. Coming in at number 2 we have Peacock Island. Peacock Island is situated in the River Havel in Berlin. In 1685, chemist Johann Kuchnel was given financial aid to build a glass foundry on the east of the island. Here he discovered how to produce artificial red glass. When he left the island in 1692, it remained unused for about 100 years until 1793. In 1793, the Prussian King Frederick built the castle for himself and his mistress. This was then passed down through the family and used for many different reasons, including being used used as an exotic farm. Although the island has a long and exciting history, there are claims it is the original Johan Kuchnell who inhabits the island long after her death. It is claimed that Johan was not only into creating glass, but that he experimented with dark magic. It is believed that through his experiments with black magic, he had cursed himself. He attempted to flee the island as to not be attached to the curse, but this didn't work. In the afterlife, he was bound to the land and his old foundry. Those who have visited the island have seen a black figure with glowing red eyes. He is often seen at the stroke of midnight. When he is near, you can feel the chill in your bones. You know that you are in the presence of darkness just by being on the island during his hour. His laboratory still stands today, and some have tried to find his old lab to learn all the dark magic and secrets that he tried to hide. It is said a fire nearly destroyed the building. The police believe this to be man-made, and it's speculated he was trying to destroy the demons and spirits he had accidentally been working with in the lab. He couldn't escape the curse, and if you don't want to meet the same fate, I would avoid visiting this building. And finally, in at number one, we have the Wold Neale Hostert School. The school was first built in 1913 and then closed in 1937 when it was then used by the National Socialism Party. They wanted to use the building as part of their euthanasia program. They wanted to make their bloodlines pure and strong, and they had the idea to use the building to house anyone who was not seen as genetically healthy. All those with hereditary illnesses or who were severely mentally and physically handicapped were classified as lives unworthy of life. They would invite the people they deemed to fall into this category to live in the facility before they would eliminate them. According to data collected, more than 260,000 people fell victim to their war against sick. This was just one of many of these facilities run around Germany. With all of the horrible acts committed here, it is no surprise that it is haunted with the lost souls. The people lost here were taken suddenly, and their spirits remain unable to pass on. Some people who have visited reporting hearing blood-curdling cries coming up the walls in every direction. Others have seen shadows darting from room to room as though they are watching those who walk there. Other ghosts have been seen looking through the windows or sitting inside the rooms late at night. They don't seem to have bad intentions, but they seem to be distraught, which can be equally as dangerous if you were to stumble across them unknowingly. Some even claim to see children who have disappeared as soon as they were noticed. The stories from those who have visited are terrifying and chilling to hear. It is enough to warn anyone away from attempting to visit the old school. Well, there we have it. Do you guys agree with our list? Have you ever visited a haunted location? Would you stay somewhere haunted overnight? Leave us all your thoughts and feelings in the comments down below, and perhaps we can do part 2. And on that note, if you haven't already, be sure to give this video a big thumbs up. And until next time, I'll see you later. Coming in at number 4, we have Zvivkov. The local forces took the lives of those there. Okay. Many have reported seeing terrifying things or feelings watches while there. What? Although the island has a long and exciting history, there are claims it is the original Johan Kuchnell.